Fox, like the morning TV.
Yeah.
And then we did, we were in Rolling Stone. I don't know. I don't remember the order.
Or no, Westwood One.
We had no sleep those few days, but I know we had to do like three things all at once and end it with a gig that night in Times Square or something. And this was one of those like, okay, stop in here and do the song on your way to some other place. And if I remember the keyboard that you had to this gig, because the other keyboard, something happened to it. So we had to run over to a guitar center or something, which does that even exist anymore? And
yes, they do.
You bought like a $99 keyboard.
Yeah, like, and ran like over the Mattel version or something.
And, so Jim is playing like a $99 keyboard. George is
just on your lap too. It's not even on a stand.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. I know. We bought it at a pawn shop for that.
Yeah, we got in a bad habit of getting lazy and buying used gear, using it for the gig, and then leaving it at wherever we are at the airport, and just so we don't have to pay for the check baggage home.
That's actually a good idea. That's not a bad idea.
The way these airlines work, it's more money to bring the damn thing back than just buy one and leave it there.
Right? No, that's actually pretty cheap. I never thought about that. But yeah, if you can find something cheap at like a pawn shop. Then you just, it's worth it. All right. So the cool version, I like this version of the song. It's an acoustic version. I don't know if that's like coffee or books behind you guys. I can't tell what that is in the video.
It's the paste magazine.
I think those are,
okay.
I think that's tape.
Those are tapes.
Are tapes, magnetic real tapes of master recordings.
Yeah. Let's check this song out right now. Here we go.
Awesome.
There's that keyboard.
Nice shirt.
Must have been mid-afternoon. I could tell by how far the child's shadow stretched out.
I'm wearing the same t-shirt as I am in the video. That's incredible.
Down the street. I just want to pause it so everyone hears that he's wearing the same exact t-shirt in this video that he's wearing right now. That's awesome.
I'm rocking the Little Hurricane t-shirt. Hey, it's because it's so soft. I love this shirt.
Many questions like children often do. He said, tell me. outside people and ask many questions like children often do. Tell me all your thoughts on God, 'cause I really like to meet her and ask her why we're who we are. Hey. And tell me all your thoughts on God, 'cause I'm on my way to see her. So tell me, am I very far? Am I very far now? Am I very far now? Am I very far now? Tell me,
there you go. You got the keyboard in there. I got to ask a question because everyone tells you to ask this question, and it's the most – it's not even that great of a question. But everyone, whenever I tell everyone I'm having to swallow on, people are saying, can you ask them what their thoughts on God are? So I have to ask that question.
You don't have to answer that.
No. Well,
God is a woman.
You do not have to answer that.
I support that.
I would be ding out my friends make fun of me if I didn't ask the question. So I did ask that. And I guess that George was saying earlier, is that like an ongoing joke? You said it might be an ongoing joke in the household now? Not from your band, but just generally speaking?
Well, no, I think it's like a saying now. Kids say thoughts on God to each other. And I've heard my kids' friends saying it, and I don't think they even know who the band is. So I don't think it's from us.
I think it is. I think somehow in this weird wormhole, like it is related somehow to Dishwalla, and the kids just don't realize it.
Okay, that's all right.
Let's talk about the 2017 tour. Then we'll let you guys have the floor a little bit to talk about anything you want to talk about with your band. You guys had a really good tour in 2017 with some really great bands. I think it was Marcy's Playground was on it. Is that right?
Yeah, Marcy's Playground. Yeah.
A lot of those bands that were on there, I didn't realize were even still playing. So it's kind of cool that reading about that, let me know these bands are still around and still doing things. Where all did you guys tour on that tour?
Everywhere.
All the places. Yeah, that was, we did a lot of busing on that one. I have some nice memories of that tour, nice weather.
Let's see. We played Savannah, Georgia.
What, you going to name them? Like, this is going to be like the alphabet song? Yeah.
No, it's like, was it just U.S.? Was it Europe? Was it like, are you guys still doing extensive touring like you did back in the 90s?
No.
No, nobody is, though.
Nobody wants to. That's horrible. I think what we do is we pick out blocks of time, maybe a month at a time or 3 weeks or 2 weeks here and another 2 weeks there. And we make it fit in our schedules and we make it pleasurable instead of horribly grueling because, you know, we don't need to be out there grinding away. It's not like the old days where that's how people learned about a record or whatever. You know, I mean, one Facebook post reaches more than a thousand years of flyers to a phone pole ever could. So we make it pleasurable, make it fun. And I like to plan tours around what there is good to eat in all those different cities. Savannah, Georgia was a great one because we went and we had some amazing seafood, some sort of shrimp dish, I remember, by the water. And then what do we have for breakfast? Remember we had breakfast and it was some sort of with the powdered sugar. What was that, George?
Oh, the beignets.
It was so good.
Yeah.
Love it. I remember the meals more than the cities.
And dives and Dishwalla.
Right. I think we should have a show because the meals for me are the most memorable part of it.
I would watch that show. Anyway, do you have any questions for the band?
You know, I realize, like, coming on that I don't really have, like, many band questions because I know them. I, like, just, like, want to catch up. I love having guys on the show. I miss you, George. And it was nice to see you again, Justin.
But you don't miss me. I get it. That's cool.
I don't know you that well.
That's messed up.
I actually was going to say that I found like that little Black Submarine cover that we did forever ago.
Oh, wow. That's funny. It's funny because didn't I make you cry during that recording? I think
did
I
did. You?
I Probably. Made you cry during that recording because I was apparently too mean. was I too mean?
I don't remember it that way, but I have a terrible memory. So
you probably just blacked it out from the trauma. Well, my apologies decades later for making you cry at a recording session.
He does it to all of us, Ava. Everyone.
Yeah, well, it's okay. I forgot anyway. If it did happen.
I demand perfection at all times.
Well, I appreciate you guys coming on the show. Is there anything that you want to tell to your fans out there that maybe they don't know or that are looking forward to some new Dishwalla? Anything about you guys that you would want your fans to know?
I want to say that what you don't know is we're all still alive. We're all still here. We haven't really been streaming like some of the other bands during COVID, and we haven't been blasting you with things to buy because, I don't know, we're just doing COVID like the rest of you, but we want to get back out there, right, guys? We want to play some shows. I got my vax. I'm good. Maybe some of the other guys are also. And also, yeah.
You know, about, I think it was exactly a year ago almost, we were asked to do a project with Alan Parsons. And we got together. And anytime we get together, we record whatever we're working on in the room when we jam, right? And so we recorded the song with Alan, and it came out really good, right? And we were working on it, whatever. And then Justin kind of took a left turn and started working on the other song that just kind of sort of came up while we got together. And that's the one that we're actually finishing that is going to be a single. So we actually, you know, in the last year, we've been doing stuff. And I would say, you know, like for me, I did all that work in March of 2020. And then Justin and Jim and Scott worked for the rest of the year behind the scenes, mixing and adding layers and all that other stuff.
That's cool. Jim, do you have any?
For last week.
Go ahead. Jim, do you have anything to add to that?
There's a lot of new music sitting right under the surface. So we've got a lot of stuff we've been working on since the last record. So. You know, we had probably 30 songs that didn't make it onto the last record. So we've always got a ton of material.
And,
So, you know, there's always options. So I think it's really just everybody getting back to thinking about being creative. And, you know, this last year has been kind of up and down for everybody in different ways. So, you know, it's good to get, I think everybody's just starting to get back into, you know, thinking about being normal life again. So, you know, we're looking forward to that as well.
Absolutely. Well, I want to thank you guys for being on the show. Don't go anywhere just yet. Stay right there. We're going to play our outro. I want to thank everybody. Thanks, Dishwalla. Thanks, Ava, for being on the show. Thanks for everyone who listens to The Loud Spot and supports us. Go to www.theloudspot.net, and we're going to play the outro. Here we go.
Right.